We all remember in April 2014 when a Chelsea second string turned up at Anfield, parked the bus and won 2-0 thanks to Steven Gerrard screwing up his life. Will there be a similar moment this season that derails Liverpool's title bid and allows Manchester United fans to make a mess of their pants? We'll have to wait and see, but let's have a look at Chelsea's starting 11 from that day and see where they are now. Mark Schwarzer. Yep, despite being nearly 100 years old, injuries and the decision to let Thibaut Courtois spend a couple of years out on loan dictated that old man Mark Schwarzer actually spent the springtime as Chelsea's number one. Now don't get me wrong, the Aussie number one was a good shot stopper, but I'm guessing when he lost both Europa League finals with Middlesbrough and Fulham, he'd probably have thought that was it as far as European adventures were concerned. Not at the age of 41, he was lining out against Atletico in a Champions League semi-final. Schwarzer has since bowed out of football, having won the league at Leicester City. Cesar Azpilicueta, the only survivor from the starting 11, it's hard to believe how long Cesar Azpilicueta has been at Chelsea. For God's sake, next season will be his 8th at Stamford Bridge. And still, there are some commentators out there who sound like they're choking on a pineapple whenever they try to pronounce his name. At the moment, Azpilicueta is probably sitting at home, staring into blank space as he contemplates how he's supposed to make a career in the same defence as David Luiz, or Sergio Bob and Asset as he's more commonly known. Branislav Ivanovic, a genuine hero at Chelsea who won every trophy possible in his 9 years at the club. Considering he wasn't even able to get in the team for the first 6 months, that is pretty incredible. Anyway, he returned to Russia via Zenit St. Petersburg in 2017, and that's where he is. Thomas Kalas. Some younger Chelsea fans might be thinking, who the hell is this guy, and how was he ever near starting 11 for my team, and especially at Anfield? It's a fair question, but with Mourinho effectively shepherding his main players, protecting them for the Champions League semi-final, he was forced to hand a debut to the 19-year-old Kalas, who then kept a clean sheet and slammed a header against the crossbar. He was so impressive that many started tipping him to break through and succeed John Terry, but don't be silly, modern Chelsea have about as much respect for the youth as your local parish priest, and have since sentenced him to several loan spells. He's currently 25 and out on loan at Bristol City. Just face it, lad, Mauricio Sarri probably doesn't even know who you are. Ashley Cole. At the age of 33, Ashley Cole was squeezing out the final morsels of his shelf life in these final few weeks of his Chelsea career. He did well and kept Raheem Sterling quiet, still missed out on a trip to the World Cup though. So off he went to Roma, where he didn't do much other than play in a defence that conceded 7 at home to Bayern Munich. But even though he wasn't there long, at least he proved really popular with his teammates. In 2016, he signed for LA Galaxy to wind down his career in the sun before finally being dragged back to England this year to play under Frank Lampard at Derby County. John Obi Mikel. Another man who currently resides in the Championship is John Obi Mikel, as he's no doubt given instructions by Tony Pulis at Middlesbrough to just kick 5 shades of shite out of the opposition at any given moment. Ever since his kidnapping in 2005, Mikel has been a much criticised figure, with some fans wondering what the hell was his point. Listen, you don't play nearly 400 games for Chelsea during the most successful period in the club's history without having something about you. Anyway, he left for the riches of China in 2017, but just like most, clearly got bored of stuffing his pockets with cash whilst playing with a bunch of lads who don't know the offside trap, and now plays for Middlesbrough. Nemanja Matic. Okay, so who would have thought Nemanja Matic would have ended up playing under Jose Mourinho at Old Trafford within 3 years? Yeah, not me either. But after winning 2 league titles at Chelsea, off he went to Man United for £40 million in 2017. Frank Lampard. Within a year, Chelsea's all-time record goal scorer was signing for New York City, and then subsequently pissed off the majority of their fans by getting distracted by a loan offer from Man City. Not only does he sign for Chelsea's title rivals, but he ends up scoring an equaliser against them, and judging by the look on his face, he honestly looked like he was about to burst into a flood of tears. He eventually remembered he'd signed for that team in the MLS, and no doubt reluctantly trudged back, swapping the likes of Aguero and Toure for Patrick Mullins and Josh Saunders. He's currently the manager of Derby County, where he's done well, but no doubt probably closes every curtain in his house before bed, for fear of a Chilean manager lurking in the bushes. André Schürrle. André Schürrle was a popular player at Chelsea. He'd actually popped up with some crucial goals during his 2 years in West London. Within a few months, he was battering one home against Brazil in the World Cup semi-final. Most won't remember it though, considering it was a drop in an avalanche of goals that made David Luiz question whether football was for him. Schürrle has since spent time at Wolfsburg and Borussia Dortmund, and at the moment is sailing headfirst into the Championship with Fulham. Mohamed Salah. Yeah, most won't remember, and he'll probably want to keep this to himself, but Mo Salah was on the pitch when Liverpool tossed away their last title challenge. Seen as nothing more than a reserve player under Jose Mourinho, the Portuguese was happy to toss him onto the pitch, throwing him to the ravenous tackles of John Flanagan. Of course, Salah had nothing to worry about. Clearly, Mo didn't look feminine enough for Flanagan to give a good lashing to. If someone told you that within 5 years, Salah would not only be leading a Liverpool title charge, but would actually have emulated the work of Luis Suarez, you'd be laughing them out of the building. Dembaba. Well, we all remember this man's contribution. Steven Gerrard slips in his own half, Dembaba seizes upon it and charges towards Simon Mignolet's goal before dispatching it home. And with that, Liverpool's title challenge splits in half. Ba has since had his own bad luck with injury, but he's out in Turkey now with Istanbul Başakşehir, where he gets to play every day with Alavior, Clichy and Rabinho, a man who by all rights should have been jailed years ago. All I'll say is thank Christ it was Gerrard who messed up, considering his already godlike status. I can't help but think of Colo Torre giving it to Dembaba. He'd have been chased into the Irish Sea.